There are so many AI tools available to us nowadays. Frankly, it can be overwhelming. So in this video, I'm going to be demonstrating five key AI tools that sports science practitioners can use to analyze data, conduct literature searches, and just work more effectively and more efficiently. I'm Jo Clubb, founder and sports science consultant at Global Performance Insights. So, of course, we have ChatGPT, the infamous large language model, which really kind of exploded this AI revolution into everyday society and life. Now, I do have a couple of other videos, tutorials showing you how you can use ChatGPT for sports science research. I'll just give you now a quick demonstration. In particular, I want to show you a relatively new feature that ChatGPT has brought out. What I want to show you now is this reason option that was recently added to ChatGPT, in which it thinks before responding and hopefully gives us then more in-depth answers. So should athletes seek more than population match controls in the general population? And let's see now how it responds. So with the reasoning response, it gives us this time frame for how long it reasoned. We can click down and get its kind of thinking process behind it based on its reasoning. So the short answer is usually yes, athletes should sleep more to support their training and overall performance. Some research shows that athletes often sleep less than 8 hours per night, so sleep extension could improve performance. It's worth noting that individual needs may vary and quality sleep is essential for optimal results. To be honest, that's kind of the response I would give, a yes with a caveat. It also gives us our key points as well as an overall conclusion in response. So for more on ChatGPT, definitely have a look at my other videos diving in much deeper into this tool. Next up, we have Julius, which is described as your AI data analyst. And of course, with all the data that we're dealing with in sports science, this could be a really useful tool. It has the ability to create charts, to manipulate your data, to provide insights and conclusions, and potentially even reports from your data sets. Now, of course, we have to be really careful as well about data security and whether we actually have the ability to put our raw data into this system. So of course, first and foremost, be careful with that. So let's take a look at the platform, and I will put a link below if you want to have a try and sign up for Julius yourself. And you can see that we have some prompts or some workflows as templates that they've created. I'm going to add a file here. So I've added an example GPS file, anonymized athlete data for a single day. And you can see then how quickly that analyzed and popped up my data set here. We can see here it's providing some clarification to give us a kind of a description, I suppose, so you can validate that it is understanding your data set in a broad sense correctly. So I'm going to now chat with the data set. I'm going to ask, how does meterage per minute in the session vary by positions? And here then we have its response. So like a number of these tools that we're seeing, they provide you with the code here in Python, which is great, firstly, from a validation standpoint and checking the steps that it's done. But also then, if you are trying to code yourself, it can be kind of your support tool in, and that you could then copy or edit the code if you have that knowledge. That actually, it's gone ahead and created, firstly, a box plot for that session period only, because there was drills in that data set as well, with the meterage per minute. Box plot displayed according to the player position in the spreadsheet, and then also provided some descriptive data as to mean, median, standard deviation, minimum, and maximum. Plus, here is given us a brief summary in prose of what it's seeing in response to our question. So obviously they're just a quick, simple example. To me, that's really exciting there, that we can just chat with everyday language with our data and get not just responses in terms of tables and data visualizations, but also the code. And as well, with the paid versions of Julius, we get deeper insights, reasoning, where it explains how it came to its solution. So Julius AI, definitely a tool for sports scientists to have a look at. So here we have SciSpace, supposedly the fastest research platform ever. and an all-in-one AI tool. And that's what's interesting as well, I think, with all these tools is, although they have a specialty, they're kind of trying to do everything. You can see here that we've got our research tools in terms of literature reviews and chatting with PDFs, but we've also got some relating to citations. We've got a tool to turn research into video, which of course is important for science communication. So lots of potential avenues of interest for us. But the main use then of SciSpace is to help us with our research queries. We have three levels of detail. We have our standard, our high quality, and our deep review. So let's go in the middle to start with and have a look. If we ask it this question with high quality level of detail, what is its response? So at the top here, as part of the three plan, we get top five papers and the answer. Eccentric hamstring strength is a key factor in preventing lower limb injuries as it helps in stabilizing the knee joint and controlling the deceleration of the leg during high speed activities. And it gives us more information here then with citations and active links to the papers. And these are particularly recent. We see here January 2025 paper, which was just a couple of weeks ago. And then we can also delve deeper. So here it's returned 10 papers for us. We can actually customize our table as much as we want. So this is the default in terms of returning the paper information with insights, but perhaps we want to add our conclusion column, maybe as part of our critical thinking, which is still important skill set, regardless of the development of all these tools. We want to add limitations there to have a look at as well. And we can see more features here in terms of creating a podcast from that paper, chatting with the paper and requesting the PDF. So here where we have an open access paper number 7, when the PDF is available, it then provides it to us immediately. If the paper is not available, open access, and we have to request it, we have the ability to add a message. I presume that is looking up the email from the PDF of the corresponding author and then potentially sends them a request for the paper. So a great way of accessing full text papers. And let's just use
our
chat function here. And I'm going to see, I'm just going to use this first example here. Were there any unexpected or surprising results reported in this paper? It's responded with some of the limited evidence. In summary, then, the review reveals unexpected results regarding the effectiveness of eccentric exercises, the lack of research on other modalities, the focus on terminal swing phase. And so we also have the ability to save a lot of these notes into a notebook as well. And whether that's specific responses to our chats or some of the findings here in the paper, you can see here when we hover, we also get a save to notebook option. And so again, not just in terms of search, but also organizing our research together and keeping track of all our notes. And this is going to link as well with another tool that I'm going to show you. So we've been looking at some of these kind of generic chatbots and large language models and how we can apply them to sports science. But this tool, Sports Science AI, I want to show you because obviously, as per the name, it has been built specific for our industry. So Sports Science AI is being developed by Kevin Venn, and he has kindly given me access to the beta version of this. So it's already exciting, and I'm sure it's going to get even more exciting in future. And when we log into our dashboard, we can see some of the stats about just how much sports science related research they have in their database. And currently, we have two main features, really. We have a literature review and chat with PDF. So with our literature review, you can see a number of different chats that I've already had. Most recently, I was asking around submaximal fitness tests, and it responds with a summary paragraph from which we can then show the sources that underpinned its conclusion there. So I'm going to ask about the dynamic strength index. For anyone who's not familiar with that, then I do have a video on that topic talking about it. and let's see what it responds with. And of course, I've started very broadly here, like I like to with my prompts. I tend to start broad and then drill down into what I want more specifically. So it's provided a concise summary of the key points. Okay, that is a good summary. Having a quick look at that. Again, we get our sources with our link. And yep, some really key papers there. I want to ask about the limitations. We've spoken a little bit about this before. Of course, it's just a simple ratio, which makes it nice and easy to use, but of course, naturally comes with some limitations. I'm also interested there that what about its limitations? So clearly this is a conversational style because it's not treating each question in a standalone format. Otherwise, I'd have to specify dynamic strength index again. So it knows that this is a continuing conversations. And it's provided us with our limitations of the dynamic strength index here. And those are, yeah, really good responses. And again, we get our source list that it's used along with access to the papers. So that's the literature review option. And then we also have a chat with PDF function. So start by uploading a PDF document. I am going to give it a pretty new paper that's just been published on submaximal fitness testing and see what it comes back with. Immediately provides a summary of the paper. So validity and sensitivity of the submaximal fitness test for assessing cardiorespiratory fitness and response to training load in female football players. Told me about the subjects and the study found that heart rate at the end of exercise of the submaximal fitness test showed a significant decrease, indicating improved fitness, and suggested therefore that this is a reliable and sensitive method for assessing cardiorespiratory fitness in female football players. As the name suggests, then we can then also chat with the PDF. It doesn't just provide us a summary, but we can ask specific questions about the subjects, about the methodology. And I'm going to be demonstrating that in another video that will come out on the channel next week, in which I provide a much deeper dive into sports science AI specifically. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on that video. And if it's already released by the time you're watching this, then I'll put a link below. And also, Kevin has kindly provided a discount code for Global Performance Insights viewers for 10% off the first 2 months of the premium plan. So I'll put all the information relating to that below and keep a look out for that video diving much deeper into the sports science AI tool. Finally, and probably the one I'm most excited about, is Google's NotebookLM. Of course, we have so many notes in our field, whether that is the notes that we've seen in some of the other tools by searching for and looking through research, whether that's notes from attending conferences or watching online videos or doing online courses. We can really use this AI tool to help synthesize that information into summaries. Here is our dashboard within our notebooks then, and we start by adding sources. So I've just selected four PDFs from my computer on the topic of complex systems as it relates to sports injuries. We can see then that there are a number of different types of sources we can upload. It's not just for PDFs. In this case here, then I'm going to paste this URL on the same topic. And we get up to 50 sources in each notebook then. We can see that we get a summary. You'll see we have the save to note option, which then adds these notes down here in this section so we can keep hold of some of these snippets. We can then immediately start to chat with the information in our notebook down here. So I'll ask this first prompt here: how does a complex system approach shift sports injury prediction and prevention? So then we get our response, and it's giving us these interactive citations to then dive deeper to look into that specific statement that is provided. So for instance here, aspects of a complex systems approach includes nonlinearity, outputs are not always proportional to inputs, and small adjustments may lead to large changes. And we can click on that citation and immediately go to the specific source, as well as the specific part within our source that has provided the information there that it's used to summarize it. We can request a briefing document. And I suppose this is a great way if you are going into a meeting or a presentation on a topic, that you can get the system to give you a quick overview, a one pager perhaps that you can print off or look through just to remind you of the key points. And that is saved over here. We have a study guide option as well. We can see here then our study guide provides us with key concepts as well as a quiz on the topic to test yourself if you want to. So really useful for students, of course. And then we also can generate an audio overview. I'm not going to get into that now. I'm going to demonstrate that in a separate video, but that's really interesting, in which it creates essentially a podcast style interview talking about your sources, and you can even interact with it and cut in and ask questions of the presenters. So NotebookLM, really interesting tool for creating what has been described as our second brain and really helping us synthesize all our notes together. So those were today's five AI tools that are available right now for sports science practitioners to use to help them work more efficiently. And of course, there are a whole host of other tools available to us. So I would love to know if you are using any others, some that you recommend that you feel I have missed, then please do comment below. Otherwise, keep a look out for that deeper dive into some of these tools, starting with sports science AI. And if you enjoyed this video, then please like and subscribe to make sure you don't miss out on another sports science insights video coming very soon.